Senator and Minority, Senate Minority Leader David Hann.
Getting invited to talk. That's great. Thank you. Good to be here. Thanks for having me, and greetings from the Capitol, where all good things come from, all jobs are created, all happiness, right? That's what I hear over there. I mean, that's what they tell us all the time. Well, obviously that's not the case, but I just want to give you a couple words of information, encouragement. But the first thing I want to say is thank you. Thank you for what you've done. I know last year we had a very tough election. I know probably most of you in this room were involved in that election in some capacity. I'm sure you were out there walking with candidates. Some of you probably were candidates, handing out literature, putting in signs, writing those checks. I know a lot of you spent a lot of time. And we had good candidates, and we had a good message. And it's very, very tough in the environment that we were in to go through that and then lose. And the temptation is, when we do that, and to think that we were going to do better than what we did, to say, well, the game is up. Let's fold the tent. Let's go away. We've lost. The people don't want our message. That's the temptation, and all I would say is don't give in to that. Don't do that. And it's encouraging to me to see that you're here today, that you're willing to stay engaged, that you're willing to continue to fight. That we did lose a battle, but we haven't lost the war. And the thing that is encouraging to me is that when you think about the things that are important, that are fundamental to the Republican Party, to the conservative movement, they just happen to be true. There are things about the Constitution, about the Declaration of Independence, that talk about things about the way human beings are, that are true. And the other guys, the Democrats, the progressives, the liberals, whatever you call them, they have rejected those things. And so when they try to govern based on their ideas, we know that they're going to fail. We know that. And so it's important that we be ready to leave, because there is going to be a time when the people of this state, people of this country, are going to say, we need leadership, we need somebody prepared to take up the reins of government, and they're going to turn to us. And we have to be ready. So I just want to encourage you to not give up the fight. Don't give up the fight. The principles that we believe in are true, they're sound. We've got to keep talking to our friends, our neighbors, people in our community, to make sure that they don't give up, because what we believe in is sound. So I want to thank you for that. Secondly, I don't know if you've been paying attention down in St. Paul, but it is Taxapalooza with a cherry on top. You know, we're going into spring break, and it's government gone wild. They have completely lost their mind. And you remember the rhetoric from the campaign, and they talked a lot about bipartisanship and how we're going to focus on the economy and we're going to focus on jobs and we're going to all get along and kumbaya and we're going to... And what have they done since we've been there 2 months? We're halfway through. The first thing that we've done is we've passed the healthcare exchange bill, the most partisan bill that we've seen in I don't know how long. No Republicans have supported this. This is the part of Obamacare that we as a state get to do. We get to do that, and we did it. Partisan, no Republicans have supported this bill. It is going to limit choices for consumers. It's going to be a huge tax increase. It's going to be more costly, and it's not going to make anything better. It's going to have a dramatic effect on our healthcare system going forward until we get a chance to change that. That's the first thing they did. Second thing they've done is they spent 2 months trying to get through gun control, and they've got it so wrapped around the axle, they can't even get their own Democrat legislators to agree. So there's a hope that we're not going to get that done. We can hope for that. And the third thing they've done is they put together a gay marriage bill and they passed that to the floor. So those are the things that they've accomplished in the first 2 months, and we haven't even seen their budget introduced yet. So all this talk about bipartisanship and focus on jobs and the budget, it's not there. Now, they did introduce their targets this last week. And what did they do? They said, well, we've got a $627 million deficit. And just to be clear, that doesn't mean that we're in the hole, because we're not allowed to be in the hole. Unlike the federal government, we can't spend money we don't have. But it means that we're going to see an increase in revenue. But the projected increase in spending is a little more, $627 million more. And so their solution to that is raise $2 billion in additional taxes. That's their solution. That's their balanced approach. It's crazy. They've completely lost their mind. But that's their proposal. We haven't seen the details yet, so I don't know what taxes that they're going to propose. We know what the governor has proposed. We don't know what the Senate Democrats have proposed. But that's their solution. And what we've been telling them is, look, you don't need to do that. 2 years ago, when we were in the majority, we had a $5 billion shortfall. We solved that without raising taxes. And since that time, we've seen about almost $3 billion of revenue beyond the budget we passed. So you could look at this and say, the so-called all-cuts budget, which it wasn't, but the so-called all-cuts budget that we passed, has generated more revenue than the budget that they're going to pass without raising taxes. So our focus was try to do things that were not going to put additional impediments on the growth of the economy. That's the key thing. That's what we need to do. We need to make sure that people can have the opportunity to grow their businesses, grow their jobs, find opportunities for employment. That's how you get economic growth. And when you get economic growth, you will get revenues to the government that if we need to do things, and we do need to do things, we will have those revenue. And our challenge is to make sure that we manage our spending within those revenues, and that we do things to reform our spending so that we are making sure that those dollars get spent effectively, that every dollar counts. That's our job, and we're not doing it, but we need to do it. So I will ask you, if you have a Democrat that represents you in the House or the Senate, call. Ask them why they voted for the governor's tax bill, and every single one of them in the House and the Senate did that. We had test votes in both the House and the Senate, and they all voted for the governor's tax proposals, every one of them. Call them up. Ask them why they did that. Ask them why they pushed through the most partisan Obamacare health care exchange in the country. Ask them why they did that. Ask them how it's going to save money when we know it's going to have it's going to have a huge tax increase attached to it. Ask them why they're putting additional burdens on the economy. Send them emails, send them letters. If you need help with information, call me. We'll get it to you. We need your help. We want to hold them accountable. And our first job in the Senate, and I've talked to prospective majority leader Dowd, but I've said, our first job is to help you win back the majority in the House next year. And we're going to do that. We need your help. Hold these people accountable because we need to turn them out of office and bring back Republican majorities. So thank you for having me here today. Thank you for being here.